One of the first games I added to my collection back in 1991 was Speed Racer. You may know it as Red Racer. It just happens that I got the version released by Falcon Soft in Brazil, which had the title changed to avoid legal issues. The Brazilian market had very few licensed titles, for reasons I discuss in another video, and this wasn't one of them. However, it's the same game, as the title screen shows. I was always intrigued by the Anaglyph 3D gameplay mode activated by pressing the select button. I wanted to try it, but I didn't have the necessary glasses. They didn't come with the game. It took many years until I finally got my hands on a pair. I was disappointed to discover that the effect didn't work well because the cyan used by the game was different from the cyan in the glasses. While the red lens could filter the cyan image, the cyan lens bled some of the red image through. If you're playing on an emulator, you can load a different palette that will match the glasses better. But if you're playing on real hardware, you're probably out of luck. Maybe Nintendo's original glasses work better. I mentioned that my copy was the one released by FalconSoft, but there was another Brazilian company, CCE, that released the same game. Their version included a pair of glasses and was called Highway Star, which is the name of the original Famicom game Red Racer is based on. Interestingly though, CCE's version was still the NES release. I know this because the original Highway Star for the Famicom differs from Red Racer in one aspect. It supports a completely different system for the 3D image, using LCD shutter glasses similar to those for the Sega Master System. This system was called the Famicom 3D System. The Famicom 3D System was released only in Japan in 1987, and it had 7 games that supported it. And I'm sorry for butchering the pronunciation of some of them. Attack Animal Gakuen, Cosmic Epsilon, Falcion, 3D Hot Rally, Fuun Shaolin Ken, JJ Tobidase Daisakusen Part 2, and Highway Star. Ever since I discovered the Famicom 3D system, I became very interested in trying it. Having built my own pair of alternative Master System 3D glasses, I knew the effect was interesting, and while games such as OutRun 3D ran on a very poor frame rate, Red Racer ran a lot faster, so I thought Highway Star would look even better in 3D. Maybe that was the problem with Red Racer the whole time. The Anaglyph 3D just wasn't as good as the LCD shutter 3D. But the problem is that with the Famicom 3D system having been only released in Japan and being only compatible with the original Famicom, I thought maybe I would never be able to really try them. But I knew the glasses worked the same way as the Sega Master System glasses, to the point of them being compatible with one another. The main difference was the adapters and how they were connected to their respective consoles. So I decided to do a test. What if I turned my Master System with a 3D game on, plugged my glasses, and then also turned one of my Famiclones on, put Highway Star to run on them, and then looked at the TV through the Sega glasses? Well, I did it, and guess what? It kinda worked! The main problem was the glasses are synchronized to the images on the TV by a signal sent by the adapter, and here it was out of sync, so a very noticeable tearing was present while I was using it. That made me think. What if I made an adapter to use my glasses with one of my Famiclones? Maybe I could search for the schematics of the original and build it myself. So I started searching and found this thread at the Famicom World Forums. One user was asking for the same thing I was, and some people posted pictures of the device. In the end, they were able to make an adapter using a CD4030 and some other components to drive their e-dimensional 3D glasses. The problem was there was no schematics there, and I even tried sending a private message to get the schematics, to no avail. With a bit more of research, I found this document detailing schematics for building a VR system for PCs using a Sega 3D glasses and Nintendo's Power Glove. The schematics for the 3D glasses driver used the same IC as the one mentioned at Famicom World, and it had only connections for the power supply, the control signal from the computer, and the 3 pins of the glasses. So I thought maybe these schematics would also work with an NES, or a clone, provided I fed it with the control signal from the console, plus the VCC and ground connections. The question was, how would I access the control signal? The original Famicom 3D system is connected to the expansion port in the front of the console. The signal comes from pin 11, connected to the out one in the CPU. So I looked into the schematics of both of my Famiclones, the Gradiente Phantom System, and the CCE Top Game VG9000. The VG9000 had a 15-pin for the expansion port available on the board, but no connector. But looking closely, we see that the OUT1 pin in the CPU is connected to pin 9 in the DE9 connector for the second controller. And the same happens on the Phantom system. All I had to do was draw the signal from pin 9 in the second controller connector, plus the 5 volts and ground from pins 5 and 1 respectively. So I built the adapter following the VR schematics and connected it to my Phantom system. And it works! The only problem is that usually this kind of glasses require 10 volts to work, and the console was only providing 5 volts. So the lenses didn't get as dark as they should, and a lot of ghosting can be seen. These new TV glasses have clearer lenses than the original Sega and Nintendo glasses, so part of the problem comes from that. But I could also try to increase the voltage feeding the glasses, and that's what I did. Using a 9-volt battery to feed the circuit made the ghosting problem much less prominent. In the end, I added a step-up module to the circuit to raise the voltage to 10 volts. I can't really show you the 3D effect in this video, but you can see the double image turning to a single one through each of the lenses. I sure got lucky for having two Famiclones that make the control signal available at the controller port. But if you want an original NES, you can also make your own 3D glasses adapter. All you have to do is to access the expansion port that is hidden inside the console, and draw the signal from pin 44. You would obviously also need a pair of glasses, so if you're interested in building it yourself, you should check this video next.